Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how you can build a retractable corner water elevator with a direct level selection. This is heavily based on a previous water elevator design of mine, which I showed you quite some time ago, which had two buttons, one to go up one level and one to go down one level. Now I have a complete button panel which can have up to 16 buttons. Here for this example I just have 6 buttons in total, but it can have up to 16. The number of floors is not limited to 16. You can have more, but you can only go up or down 15 at a time. So you will have to group it into subgroups more or less. Anyway, this elevator here has 6 floors for this example. And if I'm looking at this, you can see at the moment I'm on level 3. And if I want to go just one up, I simply press the 4, wait a moment, and then the whole thing here opens up. I can just walk in there, and I come out at level 4. If I want to go down to level 1, all I have is to press the button, jump in, and then I'm down at level 1. Just as expected. And of course I can go up again. And that's that. If I am finished, I just press the button corresponding to the floor I'm on, and the entire thing should close up. Just like that. One additional feature is this hidden button down here, which can be accessed if you are, for whatever reason, trapped in here. So if you are currently traveling and someone else presses a button, all you need to do is go in this position here, press the button, and then all floors below will actually open up. You can just walk out, and you won't be trapped in there. Just a little nice emergency button. And that's basically how this thing works. Now, the minimum distance between floors is 10 blocks. They can't be closer, but they can be further apart, as you can see. How you connect them if they are further apart, I will explain it in the tutorial. And that's basically what this thing here does. Now let's talk about the sizes. So each module is 6 blocks long. The width of it depends a bit on the button panel. With a 16 button panel, it's a total of 16 blocks wide. This version here is only 14 blocks wide, and the height of one module is 10 blocks, which is also the distance between floors. And the total height, of course, depends on how many floors we have and the distances between. And with that, let's get to the resources. So for one module, you're gonna need, of course, building blocks, then 8 slabs, 18 stairs, a magma block and a sand block, a soul sand block, then 56 redstone dust, 18 redstone torches, 17 repeaters, 11 comparators, 25 observers, 12 node blocks, 5 normal pistons and 17 sticky pistons, 3 dispensers, each filled with a water bucket, then a hopper, the wooden button to represent where you are. Then for the maximum it's 16 stone buttons, so 15 here and 1 for the emergency. 2 composters, a chest, then the signs which tell you where you are. And then for the topmost module, which is a bit cheaper actually, you're gonna need just 3 stairs, then 13 redstone dust, 8 torches, 5 repeaters, 4 comparators, 3 sticky pistons, another 16 stone buttons and a wooden button, and the chest. And then, if you have a gap in between those modules, you're gonna need additionally for every 3 blocks, 4 observers, node blocks and normal blocks, and for every four blocks, you're gonna need two redstone torches and two normal blocks. And that's pretty much all you're gonna need, so let's show you how to build this elevator here. Okay, so the first step is placing down quite a few blocks, as I already did here. So our reference point for this is this space here. This is essentially the corner where the water column will go up and down. And that is basically the later configuration for the walls. Going from this corner, we go first towards the wall with the button panel. By the way, you can of course mirror the entire thing. I will just have the button panel on the right side for this version here. Anyway, on the side with the button panel, we have the magma block right below the wall at the floor level. And on the other corner wall, we have the soul sand block. Then, visible within the floor, we have those three stairs blocks here. This stairs block here can, by the way, be also a normal block. I just think it looks better with this configuration here. Then, one block below that, towards the side with the buttons, we have another stairs block with the opening going down and towards the wall. Then, from this corner, we go first two blocks inwards, leave that free for the moment. And then we have first two by three of normal blocks. And then we have our button panel, which is in the maximum configuration 8 blocks wide and of course 3 blocks high, with for the moment 16 stone buttons, and in here the signs with the various numbers of the floors. Now you may ask, of course, what happens if you have less than 16 floors? Well, the answer is simple, you just leave out some of those buttons here. And how to do that, you will see in a moment. But first, let's actually connect all of those buttons in a single redstone line. For that, we start below this button for the 16th floor, with a block down here. Then next to this, we need a hopper. Then another 6 blocks, which should end up directly below this button here. Put redstone dust on top. Then we go behind the wall and we start diagonally to this block with the first button and place an upside down step there. Then we start with 4 normal blocks, an upside down step and 2 normal blocks. Again, redstone dust on top of those. Then we go here and place 2 blocks like this here, redstone dust here and a comparator here. And what we now have is a single line of redstone which connects all 16 buttons. If I press this button here, I get a signal up to this point here. If I press this button here, the signal reaches this point with a signal strength of 1, 2 and so on until we reach with a signal strength of 15 here. And that's exactly what we want. So from one button to the next, the signal strength increases or decreases by exactly 1. In other words, when we reduce the number of buttons here, we have to do it so that there are no gaps. So we can't just remove the button number 4 or for example the button number 8 and leave it like that. That won't work. What we can do is actually remove one slice at the end here. So let's start with, if you just have 15, then you can remove this button here or this button here. If you are at 14, you could remove those two, but you might want to keep the buttons as close to the elevator as you can. And for 14, this is rather simple. We just remove those two buttons here and move this construct one block over. Of course, we don't need this redstone wire and this redstone wire here. And you will have to adjust the numbers on those signs here, of course. So this is 14. Now for the elevator I want to build, I just need 6. And unfortunately, you can't shorten the rows here. So you can only reduce the numbers from this end here. So for 6, you can either go by removing first those two, then those two, then those two, and finally those two. But then the distance here is very long, and you still need this part here at the back to connect those two rows. The better solution, in my opinion, is to actually remove all these buttons here at the end. So you now have 6 buttons here, and can actually remove this entire structure at the back here, this structure here, and this structure here. Like so. Once we have figured out the layout of the button panel, it's time for the circuitry behind it. For that, we start at the bottom here, and we start at this 6 block here. So if you have less than 6 redstone wire in a line here, since you have less than 5 buttons probably, you will have to replace that. Because now we take an output from this 6-1, running a repeater on one tick into a full block, with a torch on top, sticky piston on top, and an observer facing upwards like so. Then we go here, place another block down there, then 2 raised blocks to the side, redstone wire on top of those 2, a repeater on one tick there, running into a full block, with a torch on the side of it. Then let's go and place another block here. Take an output with a comparator in this direction here, running into a full block with a full block below it. Then redstone dust on top of those 2. This one here should connect to the redstone torch there. Then place 2 blocks like so. Take an output with a comparator from this hopper here. Run this into another comparator in the subtract mode. This one runs into a full block with another full block to the side. Then we need a 2x2 of blocks here. 2 redstone wire here and 1 there. Cut off the wire here with a full block. Run a comparator in this block and another one in the opposite direction there. A torch on the side of this block. Then diagonal to that we need a block down here with a repeater on 3 ticks in this direction. Running directly into a sticky piston with an observer in this direction. Then a chest on top of the extended observer there. Block in this gap there with a comparator in a subtract mode here, which should be connected to this wire. Running into a full block with a lowered block here and a raised block to this side. Then 2 lowered blocks here and 2 raised blocks there. Put some redstone dust there, 2 redstone wire here. If you still have a second row of buttons, this will mean that you now have a connection to redstone wire here, which you will have to disconnect using some full block. Now again a comparator in this direction and one in the opposite direction. A torch here, block on top, torch to this side, block on top, torch to the opposite side, block here, take an output with a repeater on 4 ticks, running into a sticky piston with an observer facing downwards there. Running into a full block down here, and some redstone wire on top of it. And with that we have reached a point where we can actually adjust the circuitry behind this thing here, so the elevator knows which station this one here is. The first point is to define which station this shall be. So I will have 2 floors below and 3 above this one here, so this is the floor number 3. Counting upwards. I already marked this with a wooden button, but for this adjustment we will need to place a lever here and turn it on. Then we need to go at the back here and start filling this hopper here until this comparator here turns off when it's in the subtract mode and turns on when we turn it in the normal mode. So I already figured out how many items I need. So as you can see, now with 4 full stacks in there, when I have it in subtract mode, it turns off. When I turn it in the normal mode, it turns on. That's this thing here finished. Now we need to do the same with this comparator here and this chest here. So once more, I start to fill this with a couple of items, and at some point this one here will turn on, and when I put this in the subtract mode back, it will turn off again. So now we have told the elevator, or this part of the elevator station, that when we are pressing this button with the number 3 on any of those floors, we want to travel to this floor here. At this point we can remove the lever and replace a wooden button again. Next, let's place in the signal lines. For that we go to the back, place a block next to the piston, then go 2 blocks down, then remove the first 2 blocks again. This must be a full block, put a node block on top, then 2 observers on top, full block, node block, observer, full block, node block, and observer. Then go towards the front with a full block and a 1-byte gap. Then again node block, observer, node block, full block, then node block, observer, full block, node block, and then 2 observers. Like so. Then go towards this side here. 4 blocks, then a node block here, put an observer on top, node block on top, then we need 4 observers topped off with a node block, observer, full block, then full block next to that, node block here, observer, node block, 4 observers, node block, observer. Like so. Then grab a normal piston and place it down here next to this bottom observer and this first node block on this side. Put a compositor on top, 2 blocks on top, and then with the 1 high gap we need a normal piston facing downwards, which should be next to this observer and this full block right there. Now put something inside of the compositor, so we at least have 1 layer of material in there. Then we need a block diagonal to the normal piston down there, run a comparator in this direction, another block here with some redstoneness on top. Then we need to go down a layer, run a normal piston of 1 tick into a full block, then around the corner another full block. Again, a repeater on 1 tick in this direction, block in front of it, and again around the corner another, this time a repeater on 2 ticks, running into a full block. Then we need lowered blocks in those positions with redstone dust on top, a block in between with a torch on top, then a torch on the side of this block, block on top, and torch to this side here. Then grab a sticky piston, place it inside of this corner here, and another sticky piston right there. Then let's quickly go and place a button on the side of this block here. This will be our emergency release. Then let's go to the back and place a block next to this 4th observer there, torch to the side of it, and a normal piston on top. On the opposite side we need another normal piston and 1 on top of that. Then a block right there. On this side, next to the torch, a block with a repeater on 4 ticks, running directly into a sticky piston facing downwards like so. Then a compositor below it. Inside of this compositor we need at least 3 layers. Then place a comparator here, running into a full block with a block to this side. Then we go up a layer on this side, put down 2 redstone dust here, then 1 more block here and 1 block lowered there, raised and lowered and raised. 2 more redstone dust here, I repeat on 1 tick there, torch on top of this block, block on top, What's in this on top? Then another torch on the side of this block. Block on top. And that's the dust on top. Now go back to this normal piston here. Place two upside down steps there. That's the dust here. Repeat on one tick there. And this running into a full block. Then a full block next to this normal piston. Upside down step next to that. And next to the node block here, another full block. Put down three redstone dust in there. Grab a couple sticky pistons and start diagonally to this torch here. Going up with three sticky pistons in total. It should all extend. Then put down three blocks here. Another sticky piston here. And next to this redstone wire there. An observer running into this direction here. Then we need another sticky piston next to the torch and two on top. Then while we're in this corner here, place down three dispensers as you can see here. Following that, let's go to this right side here again. First we need a block on top of this block with the W structure. Place a repeater on three ticks running in this direction, block to the front and the back of it. Redstone dust on top of this block, and torches on the sides of those two. Block diagonally with some redstone dust in between. Block on top with a torch right there. Then another block here, redstone wire here, and a repeater on three ticks in this direction. Then down here we need an observer looking at the redstone wire. Now at this point we can place a bucket in each of those dispensers. Then place your sticky pistons, three in total, diagonal to those three sticky pistons. Now it's time for some of those stairs. We start with three stairs going up here, then another three stairs going up here. Then we need to go in here and start placing our three stairs going up like so. Now this wall should be flat from the outside. And here we have to do the same. Like this. Then while we're here, make sure you place a block there and another block here. Although it might be better to actually use blocks that look the same like this one here. Then one block on top of there. Next, another stairs block here. And here. Again, you should make sure that the future water can escape. And with that, it's time to start waterlogging. So for that, we waterlog those three stairs, those two stairs, and this one here, and those two stairs. Now it's time for a test run. So let's first of all place a block here to avoid water spillage. Then we need to place a block here, which I forgot earlier. And with that, grab a lever and power this redstone line there. Now the soul sand block should be switched out with the magma block. If I now also turn off this torch there, the magma block should also retract and now the water can flow downwards. If I then remove those two and instead power this repeater here, now this top part here should engage. And as you can see, we now have essentially a water source column in the center. And if we now unpower it again, everything should get back to this configuration here. So with that, the circuitry is more or less done. One last thing to add is at the back here, you notice that I had to power this one here and this one here to actually open the bottom up. And this means that I also need to add a block here, a block there, and one below here with a torch here, which when powered will actually open the bottom up here. And for now, let's actually just place another block diagonal here with another torch, like so. And basically what happens here is if we get a signal from the next lower module into this block here, the bottom will open up. And the corresponding counterpoint is in this block here, where we simply place a torch on top. And now, once you have copied this a couple times, you simply need to run this torch here basically into this block there. But I will show you this how to do in a moment. But for now, let's actually beautify this part a bit more. And voila, so as you can see, now everything looks smooth. I also added this part of the elevator tube and this part down here, just plugged up a bit. And with that, let's go to the back here. First, place a block on top of the observer, then down. Then we need four blocks in a row. Raised block, lowered block. Put down five redstone dust here and a repeater on one tick in this direction. Running into a full block. Then we need a lowered half step with some redstone dust on top. Raised blocks to either side. Then a lowered block on each. Another lowered block here, then a repeat on one and two ticks here, another one on one tick there, running into a full block with an upside down step lowered here. Then we go up a layer and place another upside down step and raised once more a full block and then two redstone wire like this here. And with that, the circuitry is pretty much done, which means now it's time to actually copy this entire setup for each of the floors. A little reminder here, minimum distance between floors is 10 blocks, which basically is just the height of this entire build here, except for this part, which neatly slots into the gaps down here. And for the topmost module, you will only need to build for now this part here that belongs to the button panel. This part here, which is the mechanic behind the elevator, will be extremely simplified and we will build this at a later point in this tutorial. And voila! So now I have all 5.5 modules built. And now let's go to the bottommost module, since this one can be modified or simplified a tiny bit. First of all, let's get rid of this water tube below here, because it's simply not needed. And this can also be removed. So, then at the back here, we can remove this override functionality here, since it's also not needed, we have no floor below. Due to the same reason, we can also remove most of these signal lines here. We start at this observer here and remove all those observers here. And here we start below this node block. Like so. Then on this side, we can actually start at the point here and here. And that's the simplification more or less finished. By the way, I also adjusted the amount of items inside of those chests and hopper here, corresponding to how I explained it earlier. Now, since we're at the bottom module, we can actually remove a bit more from this button segment here. For that, we start with this observer here, move it, then we go back the line, like here, then we can also remove this and this one here, and we also don't need the redstone wire, and then let's go further. And since we don't need the redstone line, we also don't need the whole setup here. And also not here. And as you can see, now we have quite a bit more air in there. And that's the simplification done, which means it's time to start with the top module. As mentioned, I copied over this button panel for the topmost module. Now, since we can't go further up, we can actually remove part of the circuitry here. For that, we start with this observer and then we go the line backwards. Like so. Then we can actually replace this hopper here with a normal block and some redstone dust. This one here I completely filled up. You can in that case also replace it with a torch if you want. This is of course only the case if the topmost module is actually a signal strength of 15 down here. If that is not the case, then the whole thing here will be not completely filled up. Now with the button panel done, it's time to start filling in a few blocks in the floor until we can actually mark the corner. Then we need to go towards the back and place our sticky piston here with the block we push into this gap. Then we can already fill in the rest of the walls. Next, we need a block diagonally to this sticky piston here with a torch on the side of it. Then we go below it, place another torch there, and then another torch here. And that is basically the same setup as here. So once more, if this block is powered, this part here opens up. Then let's go and add a node block next to this block there. Then we need an observer facing downwards. Block. Node block. And then there should be just enough gap for two observers facing downwards, like this here. Then while we're down here, let's actually add a button to this block there and an upside down stairs right here. So basically the same as in the other modules. Then we go to this point up here. First we need a block down, then up again. In this gap, place a repeat on one tick. Then we go down, then diagonally down towards the back and towards the side. Put down three redstone dust like so. Then we need two lowered blocks and a raised block. Put down two repeaters on two ticks each. Then a node block here, followed by four observers going down like so. Then a node block. And then if you have the minimum distance between floors, you will be able to squeeze just another observer in there. And that's the circuitry more or less finished. Now we need to still connect all of the modules. But before that, one quick correction, and that is inside of this floor, of course, we need those stairs here, so the water column goes all the way up. And this also means that we will need to add a couple of blocks here so the water won't spill, and then you can also waterlock those blocks here. Now if you have built the modules with the minimum distance of 10 blocks between floors and have followed this tutorial, you will already have most of the connections between the floors done. So those four signal lines here will already be connected up, and also the water tube. What is still missing is the connection from this torch here to this block with the torch there. To do that is also rather simple. Just put a block on top of the torch, then we need two blocks here. Let's dust on top of those, a block in this gap here, and a repeater running into this block there. And that's the connection already done between those two floors. Now let's quickly do it one more time. Here. And another two times up there. If the distance between floors is more than 10 blocks like here, you will need to, of course, extend the water tube, and you need to extend those four signal lines here. And also connect this block with this torch of the next module down there. And if you want to connect the signal lines, you will need to add, depending on whether you need to go up or down, so just look at the orientation of the already existing signal lines, which version you need, and simply add the combination of full block, node block, observer. And at the final point, you will either completely fill up this distance without any gaps. If you have a too high gap, just add the thing without the full block. And if it's one high gap left over, then just put in an additional observer. Just make sure that the delay you add in all of those four signal lines here is exactly the same. And voila, so now the signal lines are connected, which leaves us with this connection here. For that, for simplicity reasons, let's simply go down here all the way until we reach this point down here. Then let's remove every other block, like this here. Then, as you can see, we have a similar setup or situation like before. So again, block here, two blocks there, and a lower block there. Three redstone dust, a repeater. And then we place our torches all the way up until we are just below this one here. And here you have to make sure that the torch that will go into this block here is actually powered. If that were not the case, you would simply have to add a double inverter to correct it. But in this case, it fits perfectly and can be left like this here. And that's the connection done. So the last part is actually trying it out. So let's go up a layer for now, jump in, and we are at the level floor. And then let's see if we can go down to level 3, for example. And that's looking good so far. So now we are at level 3. And of course, the whole thing should be closable. And what you also can test out is if you press the emergency exit button here, that all floors below actually open up until the last point. The floors above won't open up, but that's just as intended. And with that, we have finally reached the end of this tutorial about this retractable corner water elevator with a direct level selection. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!